Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. It is Monday. You know what that means. Market outlook time. We got to take a look at stuff that could be happening this week in FIFA Ultimate Team. Talk about what market movements that could mean and what we're going to be looking for this week in the second half, the second week of a two-week Future Stars promo. Of course, we have these cards in packs right now. We've got SBCs coming out almost daily. We've got objectives. We've got Man of the Match items that are in packs, two of which are still extinct at the time of me recording this video. And speaking of squad battles, we have issues with people claiming their squad battle rewards tonight, and I don't think this is a mistake by EA. This is absolutely, I think, scheduled, and there's a purpose but why the squad battle rewards cannot be claimed tonight, and it is basically to stop the market and stop people from making coins, in my opinion. That's what it is. So if you have not gotten your squad battle rewards yet, as I am putting this out, EA has tweeted about it. They are acknowledging the issue, and they're saying, "We are currently looking at an issue preventing players from accessing squad battles. We'll post an update in this thread when we have it." Interestingly enough, it started at the time rewards were going to be released, and then basically when they reset the competition, people weren't able to get in it and claim their rewards, although you are actually able to claim them on the companion app and on the web app, and then you can open them on console. We did that live on stream last night, twitch.tv/thefootaccountant. I do stream there multiple times per week. But what that did was, and why EA stopped that, and we're going to talk about this really quick right now before we get into like the stuff upcoming for this week. EA stopped that because basically what that does is it stops the supply for these cards coming onto the market, Future Stars, SBC fodder. And this actually makes me believe that there is a higher chance that we get the baby or the middle icon SBC this week. I think that SBC is coming this week. That's my personal opinion. I could be incorrect, but I think the fact that EA delayed these rewards and made these rewards not be able to be claimed at once, it stopped all of that being opened, all of those packs being opened, and the undercutting was not as severe. Now, there definitely are some people figuring this out. Again, they're probably getting their rewards from the companion app because these future stars are dropping, and they're getting packed. You can tell because there's a bunch of fresh ones popping up on the market. Look at all these. They're all fresh. These three right here, except for the undercut, are all fresh. That means that they are getting packed. But one thing that I would look for is in the morning UK time, when people wake up, like when you're getting this video live, like, you know, 7, 8 a.m. UK, 6 a.m. UK time, watch the prices of these future stars because they might dip a little lower as more people who couldn't get their rewards last night are able to get them this morning. So I do think that EA did stop these rewards though, because there was a ton of people that had squad battle rewards this week because of the Daniel James, this objective, which basically was entirely attained through squad battle. So again, earlier in the week, we were like, squad battle rewards is gonna be big this Sunday for market supply. And what is EA going to do? I think they purposely stopped squad battle rewards for being claimed on the game. Just because they wanted to stop the all that market supply hitting at one time. That's my take on it. EA does those things all the time with price ranges and stuff. Speaking of price ranges, St. Maximin and Inaki Williams are still extinct. I've got a couple here on my transfer list. Because these Man of the Match cards are really fun to trade with. These go out of packs on Tuesday night at like, I think, midnight UK or something like that. 1 or 2 a.m. UK time. They go out of packs then. So just watch these cards. If we get any pack supply or in the morning right now when this video is out, if Dele Alli's like under 60K, I'm kind of a fan of these cards. The only thing on Dele Alli that I'm not a fan of is that he's got a plethora of other specials, and this card does not get a dynamic image, so it doesn't have that cool factor to it, right? But Dele Alli, Man of the Match, these cards are rare because they're only in packs for a short amount of time. These at 60K right now. If you can get some at like 55K, that was the price at what his inform was previous to this. His 86 inform was this basically the same price. This one has plus 3 pace. So I think there's a little bit of demand, and I think you could see a rise in this card out of packs. I would love to advise you guys on what I think is the best thing to do with Inaki Williams and with Alexander St. Maximin, but those guys are still extinct, so I don't really know what their price range is going to be. They haven't even been updated yet. But that's kind of the update on like the squad battles and extinct card situation, in my opinion. For this week in FIFA Ultimate Team, I think there's plenty of things to point out in terms of what we could see content-wise. Now, we have gotten a couple player SBCs, but they have been actually, it's interesting. They're putting these player SBCs out for a while. Kubo only has one day left. Okay. But Upamecano was out for 5 days when he first came out. And Tierney is out for 7. So they obviously want, and Nicola Barella is out for 7 days as well. So this SBC is going to be out past the promo's ending, which I think is kind of interesting. I don't know why they would do that. Because before, when they did this last week, there were no SBCs that extended past the promo, like of headliners or even the first week of Future Stars. Actually, what I think this does mean is there's not going to be a promo, an official promo coming next week. Because if these SBCs are extended into next week, 7 days from now will be after Future Stars is over, even though Barella will still be here. The promo isn't technically ending and there isn't another one coming. So that means for me, next week will be a non-promo week in FIFA Ultimate Team, which is interesting. I do, though, however, think that the mid-icon SBC could come this week. Don't know when. Again, this is purely a guess. But if that mid-icon SBC comes, what's going to happen because of that this week? You're going to see some panic selling on the market in terms of middle icons. These are about to go out of packs pretty soon, by the way, in probably 2 weeks. But I would assume you're going to see some panic selling on some of these icons. Hullet is 5.2 mil right now. I know that's a fresh one, so it's probably a bit, people are willing to pay 5.2 for that. But a lot of these guys, if you bought them during Team of the Year, you're looking at insane price increases since Team of the Year. I would start thinking about taking the coins on a lot of these middle icons and even upper tier players. If you are really scared about this SBC, I think I'm more scared about the I think I'm a little more scared actually about the prime icon moments coming into the game over the fact that this mid icon SBC could drop some cards. But I still feel like the mid icon SBC could impact some cards on the market and impact some of these prices of really high tier cards because people might sell them to go do one of these SBCs. That's my thinking. So just be careful with that. High rateds are already a little bit inflated. You know, we like to look at some of our 86 rated cards that we invest in all the time, like an Isco. I have my stuff listed. Isco today sold for 18,000 coins for me. Is that actually his price right now? Is Isco actually 18K? Really? That'd be nuts. Actually, it looks like he's somewhere around 17-ish K, which is pretty crazy. But some of the 86s, the 85s, the 87s, they're up a little bit in price. We can check this over here on Footbin at the moment and take a look at some of these. These are inflated a little bit in price, in my opinion. The 84s are still low-ish. 85s are up 1 to 2K. 86s are up like 2K. 87s are up 2K. 88s are up 3, 4K. And then 89s are still chilling. But I don't think it's good to buy into these if you think the icon SBC is coming. They're already a little bit inflated. We got into these a little bit earlier this week, or last weekend, actually, on Sunday, I think, to be sure that we got a good price on those. But I do see more SBCs coming this week. More player SBCs, probably another another Future Star, possibly. We got Kubo, we got Tierney, we got Barella. So the Future Stars might be done. Maybe one more Future Star player SBC later this week. I would expect another player moments and another flashback. We are kind of due a flashback, in my opinion. So I think we'll get that. We also should get Timo Werner Player of the Month and La Liga Player of the Month. So not this Timo Werner will go away and we will get the whoever wins next, which could be Haaland. So I should have a video up later this week on talking about that SBC and what that could do to the market. But I think the next interesting thing that we have to talk about, other than this week being Future Stars and those cards being in packs, and the mid-icon SBC possibly coming, I think the next interesting thing that we have to talk about is winter upgrades. Because we have added all the new players that they have added into Foot. If you go over here, this new players page, they've been adding in a lot of the gold cards. And they actually added them in before this Team of the Week. Like Odria Zola from Bayern. This Simon guy, Jose Reyna transfer card. Caldara with the transfer card. Kevin Vogt. They've been adding in a lot of these transfer cards over the past few days, early February. So for me, it seems like they're going to possibly be able to start doing some of the winter transfers, winter ones to watch, and then also the upgrade type stuff. The only thing that I haven't seen yet is, I don't know why I haven't seen a Steven Bergwijn Spurs card. Like, why does he not have a Spurs card yet? He would be one of the more interesting cards that I would want to see. You know, I'm a Spurs fan, but they got to give him a Spurs card first. So we'll see what happens with that. That could be coming this next week. And there are still, in my mind, a possibility for winter upgrades becoming next week as well. Because that's like a non-promo type thing. They could run winter upgrades next week after Future Stars. And there would possibly be some buys, in my opinion, this week. Because there's some cards that are kind of down in the panic sell. And there's some cards that I could see rebounding pretty nicely after some SBCs go away. Andrew Robertson is on my prime list of those cards. Right now, this guy's 95,000 coins, 94K. He was 130K before Tierney's SBC came out. This guy's now down to 90,000 coins. He is due a winter upgrade. If he gets an upgrade, this card will go to an 87. His 87 or his 86 in form right now, I think, is also like 160K-ish. That card is down like 20 or 30,000 coins from where he was. But these cards are going to get upgraded. And once that Tierney SBC goes away, he is no longer attainable for people. So people might still be able to have that Tierney in their squads, but the hype will return for these cards that are getting upgraded. I still think there's plenty of cards out there that you can invest in that could possibly get a winter upgrade. Robertson is one for me that I think still has a good shot of getting an upgrade. Excuse me. Trent Alexander-Arnold also is going to get an upgrade. I kind of like that one. I also kind of like Jamie Vardy. And I actually like Jamie Vardy's, the card, the 130K one. What is this one? I think it's the headliner, right? Headliner Jamie Vardy is like 140. He does have an inform that's like 50K that's already risen up. But this headliner card really interests me at 140K because he's going to be going from an 86 to probably an 87. Actually, he might go to an 88. You might get a plus two because he's getting a plus three. He's going from an 82 to an 85. So that would move the 84 inform to an 86. And that would move this 86 to an 87, I guess. Maybe it would go to an 87. But this card would get upgraded, and I think that would increase in price. He is back from injury, I believe. So if you can snag this guy at like 135,000 coins on bid or whatever, I would be a fan of that, getting this card, because he's a striker from the Premier League. He's going to have some hype if he does get an upgrade. You know, we don't have the Rashford. He's injured right now, so he's not getting special cards. And Vardy and Leicester are playing very well, so there's a lot of hype around him. I still feel like, you know, do your looking around, man. On Footbin, they have some really, really solid articles on Footbin right now of potential player upgrades. You see these right here. You can actually click on the news tab up here in the top right to see these. But these are potential Premier League upgrades articles that they have written. You can kind of go down, scroll through the list here. Dubravka. Okay, Trent Alexander-Arnold. That could be an interesting one. Tomori, probably not. Andy Robertson, that's interesting. He's got a few special cards. Ndidi is one that a lot of people have looked at. James Maddison. Traore is a possibility to have some card movements because of. Firmino. And then down here, you know, Riyad Mahrez, Tammy Abraham, Jamie Vardy down here. So look through some of these upgrade cards. And I feel like that's something they could do this week on Friday, is they could start a winter refresh, basically, and have that run for a week, put the new cards in packs like they kind of did last year, and then upgrade the special cards. I feel like that is something we could see later this week as well. But again, since we are in kind of this market that is still inflated, we still have some higher prices for a lot of stuff. This week is really kind of a week where a lot of things could go down or not much could go down. It all depends on what EA wants to do with this market. Ultimately, in my opinion, we have a player of the month SBC coming, two of them maybe, more player SBCs, and then just the possibility for that mid icon alone creates a little bit of panic on the market. But since the market is still high, people are trying cards, people are trying out these new the new FFS cards, the Future Stars. It's really good to trade in. This market is still really, really solid to trade in. Look at that. Is that it? Oh, that would have been a nice deal right there on Moussa Dembele with a Hunter. He sells for like 115K. That would have been a really, really nice one right there. You can still trade a lot with these cards, using your filters, using the icon trading methods and stuff like that. There's still really good ways to trade right now in the game because people are trying out cards. And of course, these FFS cards are still in packs, right? I just looked at Malin. He was dropping a lot. I want to look at, I actually want to show you guys Haaland as well. because his card is dropping a lot right now. 170K for Mullen, so he's dropping kind of like a rock right now as well. All these cards are dropping a little bit as they're starting to get packed from rewards. People are kind of figuring out, hey, I can actually open my rewards on the companion app instead of on console. But Haaland is 2.85, and he was 3.3 mil all weekend. So he's dropping a decent amount. And he could keep dropping this week with the Player of the Month SBC that comes out. That'll be interesting to see what EA do with that. But again, this week, if you're really scared, if you're holding some high-tier icons, middle icons, you know, high-tier cards all around, if you really have a strong feeling that mid-icon SBC is coming, maybe you want to take the coins on it. I don't have a strong feeling, but I think it's possible. I think it's possible. That's my feeling this week for the mid-icon SBC. But other than that, we're just in the middle of another promo from EA Sports. And this weekend, the past few things they've done this weekend have been really bad. You know, releasing player SBCs with different stats than what they tweet out. Disconnects at this weekend's pro event. Misspelling of the names that they were giving out for rewards. Like giving rewards to wrong people inside of the event. Like as a reward from watching on the Twitch live stream. Like that's pretty nuts. So just a lot of issues going on in foot right now, making it a little bit, I don't know, just kind of a grind, like not a grind, but just not being looked at in a positive light, really, foot in general right now, in my opinion. But you guys are probably going to be grinding some of this Osimhen stuff this week. I haven't really sat down and done the time for these. Osimhen, though, looks interesting to me. A lot of people are asking about the Ikone card. Do I think he's going to rise with the Osimhen? Obviously, if you're linking some of these guys together, Osimhen, if you're linking him to somebody, this card would make sense. The Ikone card, which right now he's 269K with a Hunter. How much is the next cheapest one with a Hunter? Because if I want to get really ballsy right now, I might try to flip that. Okay, 290, never mind. So there's probably not much there. But I would still, if you want to buy a Future Stars card, I would wait on these. These guys, they're still dropping. They're still definitely dropping. I'll refresh these prices. Olmo today has gone from like 260 to 220. Hudson-Odoi has gone from 500 to 435. Valverde is under a mil. Palacios is almost 200K. So these guys are really starting to drop again. I'm just really realizing that these guys are getting packed. So let these drop throughout the week. Thursday rewards, if they got hit this bad on Sunday night, they're going to get hit bad again on Thursday. So I would probably wait until Thursday to pick up some of these cards, kind of like we did last week with the other future stars. But we'll monitor that situation throughout the week this week. Again, this week on foot, I would expect more player SBCs. I would expect a couple player of the months, more dropping FFS prices, and hopefully a mid-icon SBC, because that would really change the game in my opinion. But for some investments, of course, look for some of those winter upgrade cards that you think we can buy and then sell in the hype when winter upgrades come. If we get confirmation on that stuff coming this week, we'll definitely start talking about it. But until then, grind your objectives. And then maybe, you know, we only have a few days left of these upgrade packs. So maybe take a last stab at an 83 plus and some 81 pluses, you know. Just do it for me. Just do a couple for me. Lastly, I want to update you guys on what happened with those cards I was bidding on last night at the end of the video. I did not end up making profit on them because they did not rebound overnight. It was an L, right? It was a bit of an L. Hudson-Odoi, I bought him for 460 and 470, sold him for 480 and 475. So I lost a little on tax there, but it is what it is. You can't make coins if you're not spending any coins. So I was taking a risk trying to flip some cards. It didn't work. But you know what? We move on. Anyways, last thing. Sorry, I forgot to mention this before. This is actually the last thing. Final note. Watch these Road to the Final cards in the next couple of days. This card, especially right here, Jadon Sancho, really interests me. Dortmund are playing well with the new signings that they have. They have been killing it in the Bundesliga, apart from their loss this weekend. This guy, like 160,000 coins, he's down like 20 to 30K. He was 195K on Tuesday before the new Sancho Team of the Week came out. Obviously, it's a position change, but this is a live item. He's getting a winter upgrade. He's going to go from an 84 to an 85. So this card goes to an 88. And then on top of that, I think they have a pretty strong chance to win in one of their, either move on to the next round against PSG or win the first game against PSG. I feel like, I don't know if they have the first home game, but if they do, I really like Sancho and Dortmund for getting an upgrade. And of course, the winter upgrade is there as well. And he's just kind of down in price for no reason. Watch these other Road to the Finals, man, because they sometimes just dip. on bid. These cards aren't really being looked at, but in the next week or so, we're going to be talking about Champions League stuff again. So just be careful with these. If you see them get low, Road to the Finals set one or Road to the Finals set two, that could be a buy opportunity this week for you on foot for a little investment, you know? Stuff like that could be good this upcoming week. So if you enjoyed this video, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have any questions. And subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace out.